Now we will see the aspects on the another important P block elements, namely aluminium. So P block important elements are boron, aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium. We have seen the aspects of boron. Now let us see the aspects of aluminium. So aluminium is the most viable metal finding every part of our life. Even our capsules, tablet capsules are made up of aluminium foils. So it has any type of strength and also rigidity and also bending action. We will see the details. Important ores of aluminium are mainly bauxite. Bauxite is aluminium oxide. Major proportion is aluminium oxide, but bauxite is present in different sands in different areas. So the composition of bauxite itself takes different formula. So some of the bauxite sands have the formula. So main composition of bauxite is Al2O3. Some sands, SANDS, bauxite sands have the formula AlOx and OH3-2x. Here x is a fraction. X lies between 0 and 1. X lies between 0 and 1. Whereas in some other titanium sands, titanates, iron titanates along with aluminium oxide, they will also, this is called monazite sand. So this monazite sand also contains silica. Sand means silica and iron oxide and titanium oxide along with Al2O3. So important ore of bauxite is aluminium oxide. Depending upon the sand composition, it takes different formula, fractional composition. Another ore of aluminium is kaolinites, K-A-O-L-I-N-I-T-E. Kaolinite is aluminium oxide, but it is a basic oxide. Aluminium is amphoteric oxide. Amphoteric oxide means it will react with acid as well as base. Oxides are divided into four types: acidic oxides, basic oxides, neutral oxides, and Amphoteric, amphoteric oxides. Acidic oxides means nitrogen oxide, sulfur oxide, etc., which give rise to nitric acid, sulfuric acid, whereas basic oxides are sodium oxide, magnesium oxide, etc., which when dissolved in water they form hydroxide, sodium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide, which are basic. And zirconium oxide is neutral oxide. It will not dissolve in water. Even if it reacts with water, it will not form any acidic oxide and basic oxide. It forms only neutral oxides. Whereas amphoteric oxide is one which will form both types of oxides, acidic oxides and basic oxide. Even for the boron, we have discussed boric acid and borax. Borax is alkaline oxide, whereas boric acid is acidic oxide. Here also two types, acidic oxide and basic oxide. Al2OH4 is basic oxide along with silicate. It is present. So that is one aspect. So these are the important ores of aluminium. Now next step is the extraction of aluminium from the ore. Extraction means conversion of ore into elemental metal. That is means, so standard method for the extraction of aluminium is a named process called Hall-Heral process, which involves the electrolysis of bauxite. Bauxite is a non-conducting. Aluminium is a conductor of electricity, but not aluminium oxide. Aluminium oxide, metallic compounds need not be conductors of electricity. Metals can be conductors of electricity. For copper conducts electricity, but copper sulfate will not conduct electricity. Or copper, it will conduct electricity only by the ionic method. If it is, it has no free electrons. We will see the aspect of condition for electric conductivity. Condition for electric conductivity is the presence of charge carriers as well as mobility of charge carriers. So copper contains what are called free electrons. All the elements and all the compounds contains electrons, but none of them is free in insulator. Rubber is an insulator, but rubber contains enormous number of electrons. None of them is free. Free electrons is the mobile charge carrier. So mobile charge carriers are not there in aluminium oxide sand. So it is mixed with the sodium aluminate conducting material or calcium fluoride, fluorspar it is called, calcium fluoride or sodium aluminate, they are mixed and this is allowed to electrolyte, undergo electrolysis. So electrolysis is the decomposition by the passage of electricity. Here aluminium oxide, so other are just to reduce the temperature, melting temperature. So the role of this one, a sodium aluminium fluoride or calcium fluoride, is to reduce the melting point. If it is a melting point is reduced, at lower temperature moles can be easily formed. So the molten system is associated with electrolysis, where aluminium oxide is decomposed to form aluminium, that is 2-4 aluminium atoms along with 3 oxygen molecule. Oxygen evolves as gas, aluminium is deposited, so it is in the molten state. It can be frozen to form elemental metal. So in all, any of the ore of aluminium essentially contains aluminium oxide. Aluminium oxide is mixed with flux materials such as sodium aluminium fluoride or calcium fluoride, which function to reduce the melting point of the compound aluminium oxide, so that molt is easily obtained, and the molt, through the molt electricity is passed. At one electrode aluminium is deposited, cathode, and anode there is evolution of gas, oxygen gas evolution. This is the method of extraction of aluminium from its ore. So main ore of aluminium is only bauxite or aluminium oxide, but it is present as along with other oxides as different types of bauxite sands. Now we will see the physical properties of aluminium. So aluminium, important metal. So it is a blue lustrous nature. Lustrous means gloss, glossy appearance, blue colored, lustrous nature. It is given polish to give rise to white, that is why it is. So originally there is a metal called blue metal. Blue metal is the combination of aluminium with the other metals. So it has a blue lustrous metal, and it can be spun in the form of fibers and taken in the form of sheets. These properties are called ductility and malleability. It can be taken in the form of wires, tubes. So ductility, wires, tubes, rods can be formed of rods and sheets. Lastly, strips. So any type of material can be aluminium wires or aluminium tubes or aluminium rods, aluminium sheets, and thinnest material aluminium strips. Even less than the strip, it is called foil, aluminium foils. So aluminium foils are used as the capsule covers. So these are the ductility and malleability, glossy nature, blue lustrous nature, and it is a good conductor of electricity and heat. So can be used as aluminium wires, but copper wires are more versatile than the aluminium wires. But aluminium vessels are used as for the heat transfer, effective heat transfer utensils. These are the physical properties of aluminium. Now the chemical properties of aluminium. So whenever we see the extraction of a certain metal from its ore, the conversion to its ore state is a chemical reaction. Ore state is the chemical reaction. But aluminium is an amphoteric oxide. It is affected more by bases. So aluminium, when it is affected by bases, aluminium hydroxide, it forms sodium aluminate. So bases such as sodium hydroxide or sodium carbonate, when it is affected. So aluminium on reaction with sodium hydroxide as well as sodium carbonate, it forms a major compound called sodium aluminate. Sodium aluminate. Sodium aluminate. Along with the formation of, if it is reacting with the carbon dioxide, sodium carbonate, carbon dioxide evolution is there. If it is reacting with the sodium hydroxide, hydrogen evolution is there. Now we will see the reactions of important P block elements, namely aluminium as well as boron. So both are amphoteric oxides, both form the amphoteric oxides, that is they react with acid as well as base, acidic oxide as well as basic oxide. Here aluminium reacts with sodium hydroxide solution in the presence of water, it forms a compound called sodium aluminate. So aluminium reacts with sodium hydroxide in the presence of water, it forms NaAlO2, that is sodium aluminate, with the formation of hydrogen evolution. So hydrogen is evolved, sodium aluminate goes into solution, sodium aluminate goes into solution, where this is strong base, sodium hydroxide is a strong base, sodium carbonate is a weak base. So respective bases are dissolved in water, strong alkali, weak alkali. Aluminium reacts with weak alkali to form, the alkali is dissolved, sodium carbonate is a weak alkali, it is dissolved, it forms once again sodium aluminate, with the evolution of two types of gases, that is carbon dioxide as well as hydrogen. Hydrogen both evolve, but this goes into solution. Aluminium, sodium aluminate is water soluble, other components are evolved as a gas. So there is a bubbling observed in this reaction. So these are the reactions of aluminium with alkali. Mainly it forms sodium aluminate, which goes into solution along with the liberation of hydrogen or carbon dioxide in addition. Next, we have seen the reactions of aluminium with base, that is aluminium reacts with sodium dioxide or sodium carbonate to form sodium aluminate, but it is an amphoteric oxide, so it also reacts with the acids. So important mineral acids HCl and sulfuric acid, even dilute acids attack aluminium, whereas nitric acid, even concentrated acid does not attack aluminium. So aluminium is attacked by HCl with the liberation of hydrogen, that is it forming aluminium chloride and hydrogen. So if we see the equation, it forms, originally it forms this type, aluminium combines with 3 moles of HCl forming aluminium trichloride with the formation of hydrogen. So the complete stoichiometric equation would be 2Al plus 6HCl giving 2AlCl3 plus 3H2. Similarly, aluminium is attacked by, so here it is attacked by even dilute acid. Definitely it will be attacked by concentrated acid. Also the case aluminium is attacked by even dilute sulfuric acid as well as concentrated sulfuric acid is the king of chemicals, so it will attack. So it forms aluminium sulfate and with the formation of hydrogen evolution. So aluminium sulfate, it forms 2Al2SO4 thrice plus hydrogen, so 3 moles of hydrogen. Here Al2SO4 thrice or AlCl3 are salts going into solution, whereas hydrogen is evolved. So aluminium in general is attacked by HCl or sulfuric acid even in the dilute stage to form with the evolution of hydrogen with the respective sulfate or chloride salts going into solution, but it is said to be passive by nitric acid, that is it is not, there are some other methods to get aluminium nitrate. Aluminium nitrate is not also stable, so aluminium is rendered passive. So it is opposite to active. Aluminium is active in the presence of HCl to form AlCl3. Aluminium is not converted to any compound in the presence of nitric acid. So there is no formation of aluminium nitrate. So aluminium, if it is put even in concentrated acid, it will not form aluminium nitrate. It is remaining as such. It is inert. So it is attacked by only HCl and sulfuric acid. So acidic oxides. basic oxides, we have seen that it forms sodium aluminate. And in all the cases, it shows its valency. So, even normal aluminium is rendered positive because of surface oxidation. Whenever aluminium is kept, even in atmospheric air, atmospheric oxygen attacks, forming Al2O3. So, 2Al combining, 4Al combining with 3 moles of oxygen forming 2Al2O3, it forms. So, the Al2O3 is the oxide layer. So, actually it will be splitting into Al3 plus O2 minus. That is 2Al3 plus 3O2 minus. 2 3s are 6 plus and 3 2s are 6 minus. So, it is also electrically neutral. That is to be noted. So, these are the important reactions of aluminium. Now, we will see the uses of aluminium. Important uses of aluminium. So, aluminium in common, because of its versatile nature, it is used in domestic vessels, utensils, and also aluminium industries. Aluminium frames are there, different type, different sized and shaped frames. Aluminium frames, and another important industrial application, it finds application in the automobile and aircraft bodies, that is flight finish and automobile car or buses. So, automobile parts as well as aircraft, jet plane, whatever be the case. So, their bodies are made up of aluminium. Because it is an amphoteric oxide, so what is the meaning of this utility here? At high altitudes, it is exposed to moisture or high temperature. Under these conditions, aluminium will be covered with a layer of aluminium oxide. But this aluminium oxide acts as a protective coating against further loss of aluminium. So, aluminium is not attacked by atmospheric entry due to the formation of impervious aluminium oxide protective layer. So, that enables its use as aircraft bodies and automobile parts. Important automobile, most of the automobile parts are made up of aluminium. And in printing industry, there is a term called caligo printing, ammonia printing, caligo printing. So, this is a printing method. So, caligo printing, and these are the general applications of aluminium. Now, alloys of aluminium, important alloys of aluminium. Purer metals, even though find applications, they lack some properties. Metallic properties can be improved by mixing with metal or non-metal impurities. This mixing phenomenon is called alloying. Alloying is the phenomenon of mixing of elemental metal with non-metallic or metallic impurities. So, important aluminium alloys are magnesium alloy. Magnesium alloy is, as the name implies, alloy of magnesium and aluminium. And aluminium with a trace amount of chromium, it is used called duralumin. Aluminium durable. Normally, aluminium is not durable because it is immediately covered with a layer of aluminium oxide. But this duralumin will not form its aluminium oxide. So, it will be stable, durable aluminium. So, it is an alloy, it is not a metal. Duralumin and magnetic parts, import steel, there is an alloy called alnico. So, alnico, as the name implies, it is an alloy of aluminium, nickel and cobalt. But it is not the case. It is steel plus these elements. So, steel is an alloy of iron and carbon. So, alnico is an alloy of iron, carbon, aluminium, nickel and cobalt. So, these are the important alloys of aluminium finding enormous applications. So far, we have discussed about the important P-block elements, namely boron and aluminium. We will see some more aspects, that is compounds of boron and aluminium, borax, boric acid, aluminium oxide, their importance we will see. will see important boron compounds. First important boron compounds is a hydride of boron, that is borane. So hydride is compounds of hydrogen with other elements, they are called hydrides. Already we have studied the an important hydride of boron is called borane. It is similar to ammonia. Ammonia is a hydride of nitrogen. Ammonia is a hydride of nitrogen with the formula NH3, P block elements. The same other P block element, that is boron, its hydride is called borane. It is better finding application as its dimer called diborane. Both are important. Borane is called inorganic graphite. Whereas diborane is called inorganic benzene. Why? They resemble graphite or benzene in their structure. That is, what is the structure for benzene? C6H6. That is 6 membered ring. All the carbonyls are alternatively replaced by boron hydrogen linkages like that. That is BH, NH. So this diborane B2H6, it is in the form, in this form, it further undergoes cyclization, it forms diborane, resembles like a structure called, it is called inorganic benzene. Whereas this is diborane. Diborane assuming benzene structure, whereas merely borane with diborane, it is linear structure, both are diborane. So in this type of bonding is called back bonding or banana bonding, BACK. What is mean by back bonding? All are hydrogen coordinate covalent linkages. Boron valency is only 3. So boron is attached to 3 hydrogen atoms. Boron is attached to 3 hydrogen atoms in both the borane molecules. But still its electron deficiency is there. So it will tend to attract electron. It is more electron negative than hydrogen. It will tend to attract, already it is connected to 3 hydrogen atoms. Still it will tend to attract the hydrogen. It is similar to fluorine. So it will tend to attract the hydrogen atom of other boron molecule. But hydrogen cannot have the valency more than 1. It is already covalented linked to boron with the valency of 1. So this dotted line is called a weak interaction. It is not strictly a covalent bond. It is a weak interaction between boron and hydrogen between two molecules. Boron and hydrogen between two molecules of borane. That is why it is called back bond. So this hydrogen is like back to the boron. So already it is important linkages are three BH linkages. There is also one other fourth BH linkage is likely to be established, but it will not be established. If it is established, hydrogen would show the valency of 2, but hydrogen cannot show its valency of 2. Hydrogen is just electropositive, another one is more electronegative. So this is called, so that these are the two important structures of borane and diborane. Now important reactions, reactions and uses of diborane. Diborane is affected by atmospheric oxygen forming boric oxide, that is B2H6 combines with oxygen to form B2O3, boric oxide with the formation of water. It is attacked by oxygen to form B2. So B2O3 is the most stable compound of boron. That is why everywhere B2O3 is regenerated. In any type of reaction we see B2O3. So B2O3 is the most stable type of compound in boron compounds. So it is attacked by another one. It combines with ammonia to form a coordinate linkage. That is B2H6 combines with ammonia. It forms coordinate linkage. It is a coordination compound. You will see the aspect of coordination compound. What is meant by coordination compound? Coordination compound is also a covalent compound, but one and the same atom providing the electron pair for the system. Here 3 moles of diborane combines with 6 moles of ammonia. The square bracketed systems are coordinates. So coordinate compound cation, coordinate compound anion. So it was here it is called ammonia is called ligand. So these aspects we will detail see in the type of compounds called coordination compounds. Coordination compounds, they have a central metal atom, they have some groups, they may be positive or negatively charged, both they are represented by square bracketed systems. Here coordinated cation, coordinated anion. Central metal atom is boron in both the cases. The linked atoms are only hydrogen in boron hydride. This is called boron hydride. Boron hydride H minus. Whereas here neutral, it is attached to hydrogen hydride as well as neutral molecule ammonia. Ammonia is a neutral molecule. So it is attached to groups as well as compounds. So here also my central metal atom is boron. So it is not quite stable. So this on heating gives this inorganic benzene B3N3H6. That is B3N3H6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. This type of, so here we have to be careful about the linkages. It is not the linkage between hydrogen. It is the linkage between nitrogen and boron. And boron hydrogen linkage is separate. It has to be written in this form carefully. Boron hydrogen. Boron hydrogen. Nitrogen hydrogen. And boron hydrogen. This is called with the liberation. So it forms, it already 6 boron. 6 borons are forming. So they rearrange to form inorganic benzene with the liberation of hydrogen. With the liberation of hydrogen. So this is the important reaction of boron, diborane with ammonia. Diborane with ammonia, it forms this type of combo. That is boron hydride. So the 3 moles of this compound is formed. Boron hydride ammonia complex and boron hydride anion, which are heating gives B3N3H6. It is called inorganic benzene. So it resembles benzene structure and it forms along with the liberation of hydrogen. So in all these cases, boron forms only hydrides. Everywhere it is only hydrides. This boron hydride is mainly used as reducing agent. Boron itself is used as the reducing agent, we have seen. So boron combines with metal oxides to form boric oxide with the liberation of metal. Here boron hydrides B2H6 mainly combines with the metal hydride to form a newer type of compound called metal borohydride. Metal borohydride. This type of compound it forms, or simply you can have simpler version, borane BH3 combines with MH, that is MH is metal hydride, any metal hydride, MBH4. Standard example is sodium hydride reacts with borane, it forms sodium borohydride. This sodium borohydride is used as important reducing agent because it supplies hydrogen, it supplies electron. So if it supplies electron, it becomes positively charged. So there is a supplier of electron, there is a supplier of hydrogen. Addition of hydrogen is called reduction. Addition of electron is called reduction. So it provides means for addition of electron as well as hydrogen. So it serves better as the reducing agent. On the other hand, B2H6 is also used as catalyst in polymerization processes, different types of polymers. So in all the polymerization process it is used, and it is B2H6, it is used in the welding torches, the torch component gas. So for example, we see oxyacetylene flame. Oxyacetylene flame. Normal flame burns in oxygen. Along with acetylene, it generates very high temperature for us to fuse the metals. Here also, the welding torch gas is nothing but B2H6 diboron. Important hydride of borane. So here, borane is always taking the structure of dimer called diborane. It finds applications in the collective manner. So these are the hydride applications of boron. Hydride of boron, which important compound of boron. You will see another important compound of boron, alkaline nature, borax as well as boric acid. Borax and boric acid, you will see.